Hi friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. This is lecture number 5 and in this lecture we will study cooling methods of transformer. On the basis of cooling method, transformers are of two types. First is dry type transformer. They use air natural and air blast cooling. Second is oil immersed transformer. They uses ONAN, ONAF, OFAF and OFWF cooling. We will discuss all these cooling schemes in detail in my upcoming slides. Now, first cooling scheme used in dry type transformer is air natural cooling. So, air natural cooling is used in small transformers where natural air acts as cooling agent. And second method of cooling that is used in dry type transformer is air blast cooling. So, in these transformer, air is forced using fans and blowers to cool the transformer. This method of cooling can be used up to 10 MVA. Now, we will discuss the cooling methods of oil immersed transformers. First is oil natural, air natural cooling. So, this cooling scheme is used up to 30 MVA. This cooling scheme has been already told to you in my previous lecture, but I will revise your concept. See, this is the transformer. Okay, these are the radiators. This is transformer tank and this is core of transformer. Now here, this tank is filled with transformer oil and core and windings are immersed inside the transformer oil. So when transformer is under loaded condition, then heat is produced inside the transformer in core and winding. This heat is produced due to heating effect of electric current. In transformer, heat is transferred from windings to the transformer oil by convection. As we know that volume of transformer oil increases on heating and it becomes lesser dense. So this hot oils move toward the surface of transformer tank. See, when this oil heats, then it rises towards the top of this transformer tank. So when it rises towards the top surface of transformer tank, then here it is the upper valve of tank which connects the radiator to the transformer tank. So when oil reaches the upper surface of transformer tank, then it enters into the radiator using this upper valve. Okay, so when oil enters the upper valve of transformer, then oil spreads in the radiator tubes which increase its surface area for convection. From radiator, heat is transferred to outside atmosphere through convection. In this way, cooling of oil takes place. Now cooled oil enters again inside the transformer tank through lower valve of transformer. See, when this transformer oil cool, it enters into the tank again using the lower valve of transformer. So in this way, this cycle repeats and cooling of transformer oil takes place. So this is the transformer with oil natural, air natural cooling. Here you can see these stack of tubes is called radiator and it is connected to the tank of transformer. Now second scheme is oil natural air force cooling. For better cooling of transformer oil, ONAF, oil natural air force method is used, where cooling is enhanced by using forced air from fans and blowers. A arrangement is made such that when temperature rises above certain value, then fans starts automatically. It is used in transformer up to 60 MVA. So here in this transformer, this is oil natural, air natural cooling. But if we use fans for enhancement of cooling, then it will become oil natural air force cooling. Now, this is the practical transformer. Here you can see that these radiators are connected to the tank of transformer. These are radiators and they are connected to the tank of transformer. Here you can see that these fans are used to force air inside the radiator. So this forced air will enhance the cooling of transformer oil. So this is ONAF, oil natural air force cooling. Now third one is oil forced air forced cooling. In this method, additional cooling unit is added, that is pump, to further enhance the cooling of transformer oil. Pump is used to force oil inside the transformer. It allows heat dissipation at faster rate. It is generally used in substations. So here you can see this is transformer with oil natural air natural cooling. If we use additional unit of cooling, that is fans, then it will become oil natural air force cooling. But if we add motors for the circulation of oil, then this cooling scheme will become oil force air force motor. Here oil is forced by using these motors and air is forced by using these fans. That's why it is called OFAF scheme. Now oil force and water force cooling of transformer. Here in this case, additional unit which circulates water using pump is used to enhance the cooling of transformer. This method is used in transformer for more than 100 MVA. Here you can see that this is simple ONAN. If we use the fans, then it will become ONAF cooling. And if we use motor for circulation of oil, then it will become OFAF cooling. But if we circulate water around the radiator to enhance the cooling, then it will become oil force water force cooling. So you can see here, this is blue dot shows water circulated around radiators of transformer. So in this way, this cooling is called OFWF cooling. Now see this diagram. It shows how cooling requirement is very important in case of transformer. It shows the importance of cooling system of transformer. Here you can see that there is a large bank of radiator used for cooling of transformer. Here these fans are not visible here because they are at the bottom of this radiator bank. So it actually shows the importance of cooling in a transformer. So this is all about this video. I hope you like this video. Thank you. Jai Shri Ram.